Assistant Athletic Director for Development, Jason Sullivan. Let's talk about your role now. We talked about your history with UT Martin, but what's your role now with the athletic staff?
Well, my role is Julio has actually included me in his senior staff administration, and so we get to meet once a week and discuss just different issues or different solutions regarding all of our athletics and you know, things that take place within our department. But my main role is to raise money. Obviously we got the Skyhawk Club, and Andrew Duwandis is doing a great job with that.
And you did a great job saying his last name.
Well, I've practiced, and I've got it spelt in my cell phone the way it's actually said, and not the way it's actually spelled. But Andrew's doing a good job with that, and engaging our alumni that way. Where my role falls more with major gifts, and you know, a major gift is a gift or a donation of $25,000 or more, and you know, that could be given 5-year pledge or all at one time.
Mm-hmm. Now, if a person would say, you know, why would you need a major gift? Why is money important for the athletic department? What's your answer to that?
Well, we have different reasons. Obviously, we got scholarships. Mm-hmm. A lot of people love to give the scholarships because they know that it's directly impacting the students. But also, you know, right now one of our big campaigns is the Graham Stadium funding, and so we'll raise money for capital projects and stuff like that. But you know, we talk about this at church a lot about, you know, church giving you money and giving tithe, and people say, well, that's going to a salary and that's going to this. And no, it's always going to missions. Well, when somebody donates money to the athletic department or to the university as a whole, it's directly affecting the students. Regardless of the title behind it, it's all going for the students and on their behalf.
Right, and it all kind of comes together. The better the university gets, the better the athletic program gets, the better the community gets, mm-hmm. and it just all works together.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And I don't know if people realize that. You've got an advantage in this in that you were a student athlete. You benefited from a scholarship and playing sports. You saw how our facilities compared to other facilities at our level, and you saw teams that were very successful probably with nicer facilities than we had when you played ball here.
Absolutely. And that was something that that always made us a little jealous or whatever. And now in my position, I really feel, Chris, that I can help. And in getting people that feel the same way I do about the program with a little bit more money to give back. And when you find that right individual that has a love for the university and the means to donate, and you can share your story with them, and how it helps the student athletes, they're more than willing to give.
If someone, and we talked about the major giving, and obviously if you can't give a major gift, anything helps.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. You know, we joke around about this in the development office and stuff. We'll take the money any way we can get it, plan to give, donate in the house, something. We'll take it, and every cent counts.
How does someone get in touch with you?
Someone can get in touch with me via email. My office line is there online, and you know, there's people around that know me, and I would love to get in touch with you.
Yeah, you can call the athletic department, we'll get you right to Jason. Now let's talk about homecoming, which is coming up this weekend. It's big for you because you work with a lot of the folks who came to UT Martin.
Right, homecoming is a special time all the way around, and of course Charlie and Andrew. Andrew One is what we call him now, but Andrew Hart, they spend a lot of time working on this event, and they've done Quad City, and I've seen Facebook posts already of Rope Pool and how that started off. We got Pyramid and Lip Sync, a lot of different things, and it's just a good time where people can come back and enjoy the good old days, if you will.
Can we talk about the theme of this year's homecoming?
Oh, I don't know.
We're not old enough.
I'm not old enough.
What year were you born?
I was born in 80.
Yeah, so you missed the 70s.
Yeah, I missed the 70s altogether, so I don't know anything about the streaking stuff.
But the streaking is one of the themes, and we all know the history of streaking on the UT Martin campus and many campuses across the country. I don't understand it, but I truly don't. And I don't know if it were to be repeated, if I'd set my lawn chair out and wait 30 minutes to see that. But also that I think that Quad City, some of the themes for the tents will be the TV shows from the 70s.
TV shows from the 70s.
And what have you heard? What's going to be there? Do you know any?
I've heard that, and I don't know if any of this is a secret, but I've heard something about MASH.
Oh, yeah.
You know, being
that would be perfect. Yeah. They lived in a tent.
I don't know. Off the top of my head, I would think Three's Company would be a great one, or All in the Family, or Scooby-Doo, or something like that. So.
Yeah, my favorite. I'll be busy at doing the Squawk Talk pregame show because I don't ever really get to. I'll MC the Hall of Fame breakfast, but I don't ever have a chance to go to Quad City because we're doing the pregame show and all that. But if I were doing one, it would be Sanford and Son.
Sanford and Son.
So it might be tricky to pull off, but I would find a way to do some because that's my favorite TV show of all time, not just from the 70s, but. And if we could throw a wig on you and you could be on Esther, it would be strange, but it would go a long way probably.
I understand.
But that's going to take place. Let's talk about the Letter Winners Breakfast that's happening, and that is Saturday morning. And four members have been selected to join the University of Tennessee at Martin Athletics Hall of Fame. Former rifle shooter Jamie Collar Ray, who competed from 03 to 07, then retired head rifle coach Bob Beard, who was here from 82 to 2014. That's phenomenal. I mean, Bob Beard was the UT Martin rifle program.
Yes,
he really is.
He was. And yeah. You know, he's a great man.
Former men's basketball player Jared Newsom, who played from 03 to 06. And, I mean, a lot of people say Dominique Wilkins is the human highlight film. But for me, and I don't know if you – yeah, I guess that was right there in your period. You saw some of things that were just incredible.
Yeah, and I even seen the video today of him working out and stuff like that. He's just –
phenomenal.
Yeah,
and he's going to be here. He was playing professionally in Europe, and we did not think he was going to attend that his mother would be here, but we've learned that he is going to be here, so that couldn't be more exciting. And then we talked about Colonel with Coach Simpson, but Colonel Bill Kaler is going to be here.
Right.
Yeah.
That's phenomenal.
He's been here since 1980, and that'll be the class of 2014. The induction ceremony takes place Saturday morning, 7:30 at the Student Life Center. Well, Jason, this has been fun. Thanks for coming back.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's been a good time.
You have to come back by and hang out. And
I will.
Maybe someday we can do a baseball game on the radio and you can do color. Or play-by-play if you want to.
I could do that baseball-wise. So.
And if Squawk Talk falls through and I need a Sanford & Son assistant?
I'll be there.
Honestly?
I'll be there.
Okay, we'll see what we can do.
I can do that.
Thanks to Jason Sullivan, also Coach Jason Simpson, who joined us earlier. Don't forget, UT Martin plays football homecoming Saturday. That's a 2 o'clock start, and that's at the Graham Stadium. And we'll go on the air right outside the Bob Carroll Football Building at 1 o'clock with the Squawk Talk program. I'll be with John Hattler. And then at 1:30, we'll visit with Coach Jason Simpson. John Abel joins us and my teammate Tom Britt. For Frank and the gang, Jason Sullivan and Jason Simpson, I'm Chris Brinkley, saying thanks to Annie and Robert back at our studios of our flagship station. Coming up next, it's the Vol Calls radio program with Bob Kessling and the gang from Knoxville. They'll talk Tennessee football for the next hour. For more information on UT Martin Sports, it's simple. Go to utmsports.com on the World Wide Web. And thanks for listening to Skyhawk Talk from Snappy Tomato Pizza. So long.